Hi, this is Aaron Kanzila. I'm here today to show you how to ship IoT with Atmel's SAM D21 Xplained development board and BIPIO's data visualization workflows. So the easiest way to do this is to download our code examples from GitHub, but I'm going to show you how to build this yourself from Atmel Studio. So we're going to start by launching Atmel Studio, and we're going to open one of their project templates. When Atmel Studio loads, from the start page, select New Project. Choose GCC ASF Board Project. You can give it a name down here also. Hit OK. Now you have to select your board. Since this is a SAM D21, we choose SAM D to filter the list. And we're going to want to pick the SAM D module that the D21 Xplained Pro uses, which is SAM D21 J18A. And you'll see down below that the SAM D21 Xplained Pro comes up in the list. So select that, hit OK, and it'll create a new template project for you. Okay, once the project is up, you see it's the SAM D21 Xplained Pro. That's the correct board. First thing that we're going to do is go to the ASF Wizard and add the modules that we'll need for this project. All right, from this list, we need to add the analog to digital converter driver in polled mode. So you select that and hit add. The temperature sensor, AT30, add that. The WINC1500 Wi-Fi module. And the standard serial I/O driver. All right, so when we have those loaded, we hit apply and click OK. Now the tool is updating the files in the project to include these modules. Okay, when that's complete, you can close the ASF wizard. And we can see over on the right, we've got our basic stuff added here. Open up main.c. And you'll see you've got a nice basic template to start with. So we're not going to type in all the code for this. There's quite a bit, as it takes a decent amount of initialization and configuration to bring up a board like this. So we're going to copy it in from the project that we have on GitHub and go through it piece by piece. The first thing that we need to do is add another file to the project. So if you right-click on Source, do Add New Item, add include file, and the name of it is going to be main.h. Now main.h is going to have all of the definitions for our Wi-Fi access point. You'll want to customize this for your own environment. Specifically, the section at the top here for Wi-Fi settings. We have our example pieces in here. This is in our hardware lab with our super secret password. The security type is assuming you're using a standard WPA access point. This should work with most installations. You'll also need to go through and put in your BIPIO API hostname and the path to the workflow that we created and the authorization header over here. And these are all available in the BIPIO workflow, which we saw previously. So once you have this updated, those are the only parts that you should need to change. Save that. Then we need to go to some of the other config files. First thing we'll go to is the WINC1500 module config file. We have to drop a few things in here, specifically to update which extension header the WINC1500 module is connected to. So again, we will paste in our code. We can see this changed over here to port B from port A. Save that. Then the SPI config. And the clocks config. And then back to main. So in main, we're just going to clear out all this template code and replace it with our own. So we'll get rid of that. And start by pasting in all the headers and includes here. We have a handful of global variables defined that coordinate things. And next we'll drop in our main function. Now the main function is set up. It's fairly straightforward. So we initialize the board, we initialize the Wi-Fi, we initialize some of the network data structures. This also connects to our access points. The Atmel software framework uses a series of callbacks to handle events. So there are callback registrations in here also. We'll go through that. Then we go into our main event handling loop. Now in this loop, we have a loop counter that's going through. So at the end of the loop, we sleep for 1 millisecond. This allows us to see that 1,000 milliseconds are elapsed and send our data points once per second. So the Wi-Fi handle events handles any incoming connections or updates for the Wi-Fi connection. And we test to see if 1,000 milliseconds have passed. If they do, we reset our loops variable. First thing we'll have to do, and this should only run once, is we resolve the host name for the BIPIO endpoint. This makes an asynchronous call, get host by name. The callback will update the address data structure with the IP address. Then we check to make sure that the name has been resolved and that a client socket is not already connected. And if it is, we go through and we run the connect to our BIPIO API endpoint. Now when this connects, it's going to go to one of our socket callbacks, and the socket callback, when it sees the connection, will send our data points. So let's see some of the other functions that we have here. Here's our init board function. It's just basic system init, board support package init, configures the debug console, configures the temperature sensor, and configures the ADC, which is for the light sensor. Next, we have the Wi-Fi init, and this just calls the main bit here is the Wi-Fi init in the Atmel software framework that sets up the board. Then next, we have init network, which just initializes our address data structure, calls the socket init in the Atmel software framework, registers our socket callbacks, one for socket events and one for name resolution events. And then it also calls the connection out to our Wi-Fi access point. Now here we'll see the configure ADC helper function. This just sets up the resolution, scaling, etc. Now we have our configure serial console function. This sets our baud rate and what pins it's connected to. This allows us to see debug output from the board on a serial terminal. And now we have our getLightValue function, which reads the ADC and returns the value from the light sensor. And we have our Wi-Fi callback function. This contains the mechanisms that will get it connected to the access point. These functions are covered in the documentation for the WINC 1500 module. We have a small function to handle name resolution callbacks. All this does is take the IP that's returned from the name resolution and sets it in the address data structure for later use. Now we have the socket callback, which handles events from the socket we created. So we have the connect message. When that comes through, we're going to make a call to send telemetry, and that will transmit our telemetry. We're not actually doing anything with the return value, but you could do that if you wanted to have two-way communication between your BIPIO workflow and the board and have your workflow's intelligence drive some kind of actuator off your board, for example. And then this calls that send telemetry function, which is the last one we need to put in here. This is fairly straightforward. It reads the temperature from the AT30 temperature sensor. It reads the light value from that getLightValue function we defined previously. Does a little scaling on there, so you get a nice 0 to 100 value. Then this populates our telemetry data into a JSON message using the JSON template that's defined in the main.h file. And we populate the HTTP request template using the JSON message and our API endpoints, also defined in the main.h file. And finally, we send it off to the endpoint. So that's it. If you're following along with the repo from GitHub, you can just open it up and start from this point, and you're going to want to build your project. So you go up to build, hit build solution or just press F7. The compiler and linker will work their magic. All right, no errors, we're good to go. So the next step is make sure that we have our board connected as described in the blog post and go to device programming, which is up under tools here. You want to select your tool. For ours, it's the eDebug for the Atmel, the device, interface. Just hit apply. Pick memories from the left and hit program, and this will load our build. All right, verified OK. All right, it's loaded successfully, so open up your terminal. I want to select serial. We're using TerraTerm here, a nice open source serial terminal. We need to go to setup serial port, select our baud rate of 115.2. The rest are defaults and they're fine, standard stuff. Make sure you select your COM port if you have more than one on your system. If you need to find this, you need to look in the device manager. And once that's up, hit the reset button on your board. And we see it connected, got an IP, resolved the host name, and is currently sending data. Ah, but look at this. Sending telemetry data. There should be two data points here. I forgot something. The default linking options use a space-optimized version of the libraries, and this does not include floating point support in the printf functions, which we're using for the temperature sensor. So we need to go back into Atmel Studio, enable that, and rebuild our application. So back in Atmel Studio, go to Project and Properties, Toolchain, and then look for the arm GNU linker under General. This option here, use sized optimized library. For this demo, we don't need to squish everything down, but we do want that floating point printf support. So we're going to unselect that, save, close, and rebuild our solution. Now when we load it on, we should see both data points coming through. Great, our build is finished. Let's open up device programming, connect to the board, hit memories and program, load the firmware. It verifies. All right, close that, go back to our terminal. I'll just clear this and push reset. All right, it connects, gets an IP. Great, now we have both data points coming through. Now all we have to do is go over to our BPO workflow, check our data visualization, and we're good to go. So now we've got our demo code running on the board here and the BIP visualization running. And if we cover the light sensor, we should see that real-time chart drops right down and comes right back up. And that's a quick prototype with the Atmel SAM D21, the WINC1500, and BIPIO. Thanks for watching.